the Joint United Nations Program on HIV/AIDS warns against a different second wave in the Philippines, not of the coronavirus, but of HIV/AIDS. That's if access to testing and treatment services continue to be hampered by the pandemic. Joining us now for more on this is UNAIDS Philippines Country Director Dr. Louis Ocampo. Doctor, good afternoon and thanks so much for joining us.
Good afternoon, and thank you for inviting me to your show.
The health department says it had enough HIV drugs, distribution and testing continue, and procurement of antiretroviral drugs is ongoing. What is the situation on the ground amid the pandemic and the quarantine?
Yeah, I want to start by giving you information on the recently published Global AIDS Report. And it says that the AIDS epidemic, of course, remains to be a global crisis, and it's being fueled by inequalities, you know, and demands that we act with greater urgency to reach the millions still left being left behind. And in Asia and the Pacific, key populations continue to be left behind, and key populations and their partners accounted for an estimated 98% of new infections. In the Philippines, actually, in terms of testing, we have seen a markedly decrease in terms of those who are being diagnosed. In March, it decreased to 53%, and in April, it decreased to 69%. Normally, we are diagnosing around 1,000 new cases every month. But in the last in April, we only diagnosed 247, and this reflects, a decrease in uptake, decrease in number of people accessing HIV testing in our testing facilities, and of course, consequently, in terms of the number of diagnosed clients or diagnosed patients started on treatment, it has also, we also seen, a marked decrease of around half of those who are, we usually started on treatment in a month, it decreases again during the COVID crisis. In terms of the delivery of the antiretroviral drugs, considering the lockdown and the quarantine guidelines we had in the country, we also experiencing challenges in accessing ARV or antiretroviral refill. Fortunately, the community has been proactive in mobilizing themselves. They ask for volunteers to provide courier service and provide their own transportation to bring this ARV to the community. Mm-hmm. Particularly the Love Yourself and the Red Whistle, these are organizations that are being proactive in terms of ensuring that the sustainability and continuity of HIV services are in place. Mm-hmm.